Hi, it's Tom again. Today we're going to talk about the parts of a plant cell. Now you have a good diagram at the top of this lesson that you can either print out or look at online, but I wanted to go over them again and emphasize some parts of the cell. I should also let you know that there are other parts of a plant cell, but these are the main ones for this course and the ones that we'll be talking about not only today, but throughout the semester. Alright, so we're going to start from the outside of the plant cell and move in. On the outside of the plant cell is a thick wall called, logically enough, the cell wall. As I mentioned, the cell wall is thick. And it's thick because it's got a high amount of a compound called cellulose in it. Cellulose you're actually very familiar with. If you have printed out your lesson on a piece of paper or writing on paper, paper is made up primarily of cellulose. In fact, cellulose makes up probably most of the dry matter of a plant. Very universal compound in plants because it makes up the outer cell wall. The cell wall is thick and made up of cellulose fibers that provide support for the cell. Remember, the cell isn't just a flat rectangle on a board. It's actually a three-dimensional structure. And the cell wall gives it some rigidity, almost the way that a gallon of milk has a plastic container around it. Because the inside of the cell is liquid, so you have to have some support for all of that liquid. Alright, so that's the cell wall. Inside the cell wall is the cell membrane. The cell membrane is made up of lipid and protein, and it's quite flexible. It allows some water and some compounds in and keeps other compounds from going out. It's like the inner tube inside of a tire. It's flexible and it holds a lot of the materials in, but as I mentioned, can let some things to move into the cell. Remember I said that the cell has a lot of liquid, a lot of water inside it, and that fluid inside the cell is called the cytoplasm. It can also be called the protoplasm, but I tend to call it the cytoplasm in this course. So it's the goop inside the cell. Now we get to some of the parts inside the cell. Perhaps the most distinctive feature of a plant cell would be, the two most distinctive features would be a cell wall, because animals don't have cell walls, just plants. But also this next structure, which is the light-gathering organelle, or the chloroplast. And I'm going to show it in green. Because typically they are green in the cell. C-H-L-O-R-O-P-L-A-S-T. So the chloroplast is where the mechanisms are for capturing light energy from the sun and converting it into chemical energy that can be used by the cell or stored and transported around the plant. We're going to talk more about chloroplasts and photosynthesis later in the course, but for now, just so that you know the structure, here it is. Now, if you have chemical energy in the plant that's either been stored or is available to the plant, you have to have some sort of a mechanism for converting that energy into energy that the plant can use for growth. And that conversion of stored energy to usable energy happens in an organelle called the mitochondria. And I'm going to draw that in red. Now, plants have more than two mitochondria and two chloroplasts, but I'm just showing that for convenience. So again, this is the energy producing organelle in the cell. It's called mitochondria. Mitochondria is plural, mitochondrion is singular. Each plant cell also has a nucleus that I'll show in blue. And the nucleus holds the chromosomes, which are the hereditary material. So I'm going to show the chromosomes as squiggly strands. Even though if you were looking at a cell, you probably wouldn't be able to see them. Nucleus. The next part is often makes up the greatest amount of the cell, arid volume of the cell. And it's called the vacuole. I'll show that in yellow. The vacuole is used by the cell as a dumping ground for wastes that it no longer needs and that it can't get rid of any other way. But it's also a place for storage. So for instance, one of the energy storage compounds that a plant produces is starch. And vacuoles are one of the places where a plant can store starch. So it's a storage area, often makes up most of the internal volume of the plant. So that's called the vacuole. Now there's one more part, or at least compound, that I want to show you that's actually outside of the cell. So what I'm drawing is the adjacent cell. So here's the cell, we're diagramming the parts. Here's the cell next door. And in between them is a cement, and I'm going to show it in red. It's not red in nature. But this is the cement that holds the cells together. And this is called the middle lamella. And it cements two cells together. Well, there you go. I'd like you to know these parts of the cell.